Now I'm a scrubber runner and a breaker too. I live on damper and wallaby stew. I've got a big cattle dog with a staghound cross. I never saw the scrubber we couldn't toss, 'cause I'm the fella from Cunnamulla. Yes, I'm the Cunnamulla fella. I'm fed up. Now once when I was droving on the cattle.
G'day, my name's Nick. Welcome to the Bush Pub Review. Today we're at the Flowerdale Hotel. I hear they cook up a mean palmer here, so let's go in and meet Steve and Vivian.
Been running the pub now for 11 years, since 2001. And first time as a publican, ex-printer by trade. And decided a life change. Got sick of travelling the city for work, so we took on the local pub.
She had a lot of kiddies and a lot of bills, so I grabbed my horse.
Owning your own hotel has got lots of advantages. People you meet, obviously being self-employed, having the advantage of being able to have a tap beer when you want to. but basically, all sorts of people walk in. From all sorts of areas, overseas, local people, characters, and again, it's a necessity to the country areas. Conversation one time a few years back about someone who said, "Oh, I've been working too many hours. The boss is making me do, you know, overtime. I don't want to do it. I can't be bothered. I want me Saturday, you know." And the conversation been going around for a little while until someone points out. How many hours do you do? And I just said, well, I don't think I'll answer that. Main reason being is if you open at 10 and you close at 10, that's 12 hours. You've done that 7 days a week, and I have a license to one, and then there's days of cleaning up in between. So there's quite a few hours involved. Probably worth about 50 cents an hour if you really look at it, but the rewards are far better than just the dollars.
Always in the public view, and you know, you, whatever decisions you make for everybody, you know, you've got another local business down the road that can do takeaways, and I don't want to interfere with their business until after they close.
I live on damper and wallaby stew. I've got a big cattle dog with a staghound.
Originally, the Flowerdale Hotel was called Glen Fern Hotel. And there was, of course, which is now no longer existing, the Glen Burn Hotel. Now, I believe it to be a person, hotelier at the time called Molly Casper, who changed the name after buying it from Glen Fern Hotel to Flowerdale Hotel because it was in Flowerdale and had been confused with the Glen Burn Hotel probably once too often. Flowerdale itself was renamed, my understanding, after that area of Scotland, which is Flowerdale, and it originally was Peterson's.
Well, his name is Andrew Sibley. He's an 83-year-old, very passionate about his art, and he just happens to be a local. He's got his home base down in Albert Park, and he uses his property in Flowerdale to come up and paint on the weekends. The one in the bar is all just of all the locals, all the men in the bar. All the women are all practically all the wives of the men that are in the bar. Yeah, no, he's done a very, like, you can look at them and know who they are. There's, without a doubt, he's managed to pick up some kind of characteristic of that person. You can actually see it in the person that he's painted. It's the way they sit, the way they hold their drink, the hat that they wear. Yeah, you can tell.
Favourite time of the year is now. From Cup Day on, I always say we're switched on because we have a very big Cup Day here. And then from there right through to Easter is your peak periods. It's quite nice in the middle of winter when you've got the fires going, you're sitting around, you're having a quiet beer with a couple of customers or a local, and they're the good times. or you may have someone staying in the accommodation and they're very interesting people and you just end up sitting around having a few drinks with them and just talking about different things.
For a country pub to be successful, I think you need good people skills and a passion. It can be hard work and long hours, and it's not just go to work and go home, it's got to be a way of life.
Oh, she said her daddy's name was Charlie Vaux. She had a lot of kitties and a lot of bills, so I grabbed my horse, that was nice and...
Thanks for joining us on another Bush Pub Review here at the Flowerdale Hotel. And thanks so much to Steve and Vivian for having us down at such late notice. I'm stuffed if I know how they keep up with all the palmers that fly out the door at 12:30 when all the bikies roll in, but they've done a magnificent job of it today. Just a shame I couldn't got a little bit of that on video myself, but I was too busy hoeing into one myself. Next time you're looking to go for a feed, just pick a spot on the map and get out and check out a country hotel. They're great places to be. Next month, we're going down the surf coast and we're going to have a look at the Kilcunda Hotel. Any fish down that way, Ab? We're going to find some trout over there? All right. I'm off to catch some fish with Ab. Till next time, have a good one.
Bit of a peek over your shoulder, back at the camera and the thumbs up.
Hey, did you hear you?
Have a sip.
Yes, he's a fella.